Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Today we'll be discussing the causes and the pathogenesis of hyponatremia. Hyponatremia is defined by a serum sodium of less than 135 milliequivalent per liter. It is a very common condition affecting up to 30% of admitted cases, especially cases in intensive care units. We remember that the sodium concentration is actually a relation between the amount of sodium and the amount of water in which it is dissolved. We can easily remember how the hyponatremia can be induced. Generally, we divide the causes of hyponatremia into very big categories. The first one is due to sodium loss, which can be through the gastrointestinal tract, like in cases of persistent vomiting, or gastric aspiration, or persistent diarrhea. Or the loss can be through the renal tract with the use or overuse of diuretics and in cases of salt-losing nephropathy. The other big category is due to increased total body water, which can occur because of many causes. The first of which is what we call cases due to appropriate antidiuretic hormone secretion, as occur in cases of congestive heart failure, nephrotic syndrome, or liver cirrhosis, in which the circulating blood volume is decreased below the normal, stimulating the volume receptors in the aortic artery, which result in stimulation of the antidiuretic hormone secretion, which will prevent or decrease the secretion of water through the kidney, increasing the total body water. The other or next group is what we call inappropriate antidiuretic hormone secretion, in which there is no non-stimulus because the circulating blood volume is normal. But due to other causes, which include some chest infections, meningitis, some malignancies like bronchogenic carcinoma, there is a direct stimulation of the antidiuretic hormone secretion, resulting in an increase in the total body water and hyponatremia. All these groups are, or all these causes are grouped under the name of syndrome of inappropriate antidiuretic hormone secretion, abbreviated usually as SIADH, S-I-A-D-H. The third group is an increase of the total body water due to increased intake, which can occur orally in patients with psychogenic polydipsia, with the excessive intake of water, which will overpower the renal power of excretion, resulting in increased total body water, or intravenous infusion of excess amount of dextrose with admitted patient, which will result in increased total body water and the hyponatremia as well. The last group of causes is due to decreased secretion of the water through the kidney in cases of acute and chronic renal failure. These are the causes and the mechanism of hyponatremia. In our next lecture, we'll be talking about the symptoms and signs and the way of diagnosing hyponatremia as regards its causes, which will be followed later on by a lecture about the treatment of hyponatremia. Hope you see you again in the next lecture, and thank you very much for your attention.